my feel good breakfast show.
Oh, welcome back. We're back on the couch with comedian, radio host, TV writer, and good friend on our show, Angel Campion, alongside comedian, producer, and entertainer Mel Jones. And in light of the UN's World Youth Skills Day 2021 that we are celebrating today, which is paying tribute to the resilience and creativity of young people through the COVID-19 pandemic this year, they're going to share with us the value of comedy as a skill and a career. Mel's gone all serious. Angel's laughing in my face.
Now I have to think about an answer.
Is it a job? Is this a real job, Mel? Have you ever had to answer that question to your parents or anyone else?
That's the thing, is when people find out that I'm a comedian, they go, and what else do you do? Because they don't take it very seriously. And to be honest, I didn't take it very seriously growing up. I didn't think that I would be a comedian or an entertainer. I thought, oh, if you have to be on TV, you have to be an actor. Uh-huh. So and so it's the one thing you can't really study for. You have to have, because I was a class clown at school. I believe that.
Yeah,
that prepared me for this.
So there are a lot of teachers going, I knew it.
Yes. Yes, maybe you shouldn't have told me to keep quiet so much and let me explore my comedic side. So yes, I think it's a skill, but it can be honed. And there are little tricks and tips that you can sort of use.
I think you're being quite humble, because I think it's quite a technical thing. When I see how good you guys are at what you do, I mean, we stand on a stage all the time and try to be funny, but really...
But there's a lot of prep involved,
it doesn't
right?
Really happen.
You're right, it does evolve. So it's sort of something that it's trial and error. It was trial and error for me, because there wasn't any other women doing it in the country. There were a few here and there, and we were kind of learning it together. And it's a very different, when you're a woman doing comedy, it is slightly different to a man doing comedy, because you find different things that are relatable. You have different, you speak with a different voice.
Sensibilities, for sure.
Essentially, yes.
I like that. Mel was one of the mentors for me. I mean, not a mentor. She didn't talk to me for like the first year. She was like, please go away.
I still don't talk to her.
But yeah. She was the only female comedian working in Cape Town that I could look up to at the time when I started. So they really, I mean, and as you say, it's an interesting skill to have to hone, and you learn from your peers very much so by watching their art.
Well, I can imagine a lot of people are also learning from you, being an award-winning writer for television.
And she also writes for TV. Don't learn from me.
Did you just raspberry us?
Well, I was about to ask you, how can someone that's got a passion for writing, well, able to get into that field?
Well, to Mel's point, she was the class clown. I wasn't necessarily the clown, I was the chatterbox, but my matric English teacher, her goodbye thing in my card was, please be a writer.
And got cards when you went to matric?
Yes, fancy schools.
Still a got a goodbye.
It comes with a sense of entitlement.
The cover said good riddance.
Okay. And then you get to sit on TV after that. Yeah.
But the thing with writing, I think, that if you're a young person wanting to be a writer, read. Reading is the first step to writing. I had no friends growing up, so I read a lot of books. That was my friend.
So be lonely. Class clown. Those are the skills we're trying to teach.
But read good. I can imagine, like, you know, be picky with the writers whose books you're going to be reading, so that it's not your E.L. James and like.
That book made me so angry. I finished it and I was just like, the grammar is so wrong. She did beautiful twice in a sentence. But no, yes, because the voice in your head is
no, yes.
So...
Clearly she was well-read, this one.
Mel?
Please. This is why we need microphones. It's my turn. No, the voice in your head is so powerful. We all know that. The positive thoughts you have, the negative thoughts. And when you're reading, you're subconsciously programming your brain to think the words that this author has put in. So reading other comedians' biographies, autobiographies, all of those things is a great way to start building the library of skills.
What is it that allows you to stand up in front of a room full of people? Because I've realized in the presenting, the one gift it's given us is that I can now sell stuff, because I can make an emotional connection, and I love the sound of my own voice, and those two things connected. they work really well together. But you've done international comedy festivals. You've got to stand up in front of a packed room full of people that you've never met before. That must be terrifying. What kind of public speaking skills have you honed through your comedic journey?
I think that a lot of the time it's a conversation that you have with yourself, and no matter who you are, no matter how many times you've been up in front of an audience, you still get a little terrified at times. So there's a bit of a self-talk that I have before the time, and I kind of go, you know what? People need to hear what you've got to say as much as you need to say it. Yeah. And especially for comedians nowadays, people need to laugh more than anything. So as much of a privilege as it is for me to stand in front of people, it's also a responsibility. I also have a responsibility to kind of make people laugh. And not a lot of people can do it, so I've got to do it. And I owe it to them to kind of do the best job that I can. So that's the self-talk that I have.
I'm going to steal your pep talk about people need to hear more about what you have to say than you have to say it. Yeah. Normally, my pep talk to myself is, "You're not going to cry."
No,
I'm going to cry. Don't cry.
I actually say that quite a lot as well to myself. Yeah, I had a good cry yesterday. I almost cried this morning. When we spoke about Cotlins. But please don't forget to catch these two phenomenal comedians and an amazing lineup. Probably the best in the country for 67 minutes of laughter. It's a virtual show. Go to quicket.co.za to get all of the just $100. That's nothing. And most importantly, I just want to add to this conversation.
Skill.